गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू लॉरेल क्लासेस। सो सिंस द वेरियस डिमांडिंग ऑन द करंट इश्यूज और करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ द अरुणाचल प्रदेश, सो वी आर कमिंग ऑन द करंट अफेयर्स सीरीज फ्रॉम लॉरेल क्लासेस। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोटेक्टेड एरियाज ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश। So why we are taking this topic, protected areas? So this topic is not just important for prelims but mains as well, and 3 to 4 questions are coming every year in prelims in APPSC. So first we'll see what is protected area. So it is a type of in situ conservation where any biological species conserved in their own habitat range. So what is in situ conservation? So in situ conservation where any species like any flora or fauna species conserved in their own habitat like national park, biosphere reserve, wildlife sanctuaries are called in situ areas. Second, protected area is nothing but it is a conservation strategies used in the management of biological and environmental resources exist in the area. Next, protected area established by the government actions, often as national level but also local and regional level. So protected areas are mostly notified by the government, local state government, and after that the central government. The IUCN 1985 has developed the following system of classification for protected area that ranges from minimal to intensive allowed use of the habitat by the man. So here we will discuss 3 major protected areas: national park, wildlife sanctuaries, and biosphere reserve. So first we'll discuss about the national park. So national park, they are large area and national, which is a national beauty maintained for scientific, educational and recreational use. They are not usually used for the commercial extraction of resources. So national parks are highly restricted areas which are not open for all, whereas wildlife sanctuaries have lesser restrictions than national parks. The other difference between national park and wildlife sanctuaries is national park clearly restricted marked boundaries, whereas wildlife sanctuaries have not permanent boundaries. So any protected areas are having 3 zones: core zone, buffer zone and transition zone. So core zone is a fully restricted area for any kind of human activities. Now second is buffer zone. Buffer zone is slightly restricted where tourists can go and research activities also can be done on the buffer zone. Third one is the transition zone or the outer zone. So transition zone is the zone where the fringe areas, villagers are living there and they can extract the plant resources, tree resources from there, and they do farming and other human activities in the transition zone. So the dependent species, dependent villages are live in the transition zone only. Now next is biosphere reserve. They are also restricted, strict for conservation of endemic and threatened flora and fauna species. So what is endemic and what is threatened? So endemic means the species which are found only those area and therefore they are not found anywhere else. Threatened species which are going to be vanished or which are going to be endangered are called the threatened species. So it is a part and international network of preserved area designated by the United Nations Educational Society and Cultural Organization, UNESCO. Now what is the contribution of our country in protected areas? So India is rich with rare, threatened and endemic flora and fauna species. For the conservation of our existing biological resources, Government of India declared 2,998.9 square kilometer area for biosphere reserve and 40,501.13 square kilometer area for national park and 119,775.80 square kilometer area for wildlife sanctuaries. So here you can see the national park, wildlife sanctuary and biosphere reserve data, which is basically not important for your prelims, but still you just see total national parks in India is 104 and total wildlife sanctuary is 501 and total biosphere reserve is 18 biosphere reserve. Now what is the contribution of state Arunachal Pradesh? So Arunachal Pradesh is having different national park, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserve and tiger reserve. So here 2 national park, 11 wildlife sanctuaries and 1 biosphere reserve and 3 tiger reserve is declared by the Government of India. And these data is important for the prelims as well. This is the map, you can see it's the old map of 2015. So here you can see different protected areas are situated in different district and distinct different parts of the state. Now first we will see the biosphere reserve. So Arunachal Pradesh is having one of the biggest biosphere reserve, Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve. This biosphere reserve is established in the Siang and Dibang Valley, which is established in 1998, and it covers the total area of 5,105.5 kilometer. This area is actually famous for their many endemic species and which is famous for the Mismi Takin is the species which is found in the Mismi Hills only, and Mismi Hills is situated in the Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve. And there are so many species which are found only in this area, in this Mismi Hills, which is famous for this landscape or this Dihang Dibang Biosphere Reserve. And basically, what we have discussed earlier, biosphere reserve are made for the endemic and threatened flora and fauna species. Now the next is national park. Arunachal Pradesh is having 2 national park, Namdafa National Park and Moling National Park. So Namdafa National Park is situated in Changlang district, which is established in 1983, and it covers the total area of 1807.82 kilometer square. And Namdafa National Park is famous for the red panda, which is a threatened species. And you can also see leopard, tiger, elephant, musk deer and so on, many species. Next is Moling National Park. Moling National Park is situated in the Upper Siang district, which is established in 1986, and it covers the total area of 483 kilometer square. And this national park is also famous for the elephant and tigers. Now we'll see wildlife sanctuaries. So Arunachal Pradesh is having 11 wildlife sanctuaries, and each wildlife sanctuary is having different kind of flora and fauna species. So first we will see Pake Wildlife Sanctuary. So Pake Wildlife Sanctuary is situated is in Pake Kesang district, which is established in 1977. And it covers the total area of 861.95 kilometer square. So this is actually a very famous wildlife sanctuary in Arunachal Pradesh. Why? Pake Wildlife Sanctuary is recently started Pake Paga Hornbill Festival. So hornbill are the attraction species of this wildlife sanctuaries. And in 2014, government had started Pake Paga Hornbill Festival as a district festival, but in 2018 the government take initiative and the district festival has been converted on state festival, and every year in from 18 to 20 January, the Hornbill Festival has been celebrated in this area. Now, second is Dirang Memorial or Lali Wildlife Sanctuary. This wildlife sanctuary is situated in East Siang district and establishes 1978, and it covers the total area of 190 kilometer square area. Third one is Itanagar Wildlife Sanctuary. It is situated in Papumpare district and established in 1978, and it covers the total area of 140 kilometer square. Now the fourth one is Mehao Wildlife Sanctuary. Mehao Wildlife Sanctuary is situated in Lower Dibang Valley, which is established in 1980, and it covers the total area of 281.5 km square. And Mehao Wildlife Sanctuary is famous for the Huluk Gibbon species. So in the slide you can see the monkey species. It is Huluk Gibbon. Now the fifth one is Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary. So I think everyone is known for this wildlife sanctuary. It is situated in East Kameng district and establishes 1989, and it covers the total area of 217 km square. Now the attraction species of this wildlife sanctuary is Bugun Leo Chichla. Bugun Leo Chichla is recently discovered from Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary, which is named by their tribal community Bugun. So this species is found only in this wildlife sanctuary in the entire world. So that's why this wildlife sanctuary is famous, and you can see lots of rare bird species are here. Now the next is Kamlang Wildlife Sanctuary. Kamlang Wildlife Sanctuary is situated in Lohit district, which is established in 1989, and it covers the total area of 783 km square. And this wildlife sanctuary is famous for their tigers only. Now the next is Sesa Orchid Wildlife Sanctuary. It is situated in West Kameng district, which is established in 1989, and covers the total area of 100 km square. So as you can see by the name Sesa Orchid, orchid is a plant species which is a parasite species of tree. So this wildlife sanctuary is only famous for the orchid species. Except that there are so many wildlife species are also there, but this is only famous for the orchid. That's why it's the government has given their name Sesa Orchid Wildlife Sanctuary. Now next is Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary. Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary is situated in Dibang Valley. It is established in 1991 and covers the total area of 4149 km². It is the largest wildlife sanctuary in the Arunachal Pradesh. So this wildlife sanctuary is famous for the tigers as well as many rare flora and fauna species, many bird species, many mammal species and many plant species which are very rare is found in the Dibang Wildlife Sanctuary. Now next is Kane Wildlife Sanctuary. This wildlife sanctuary is situated in West Siang district and established in 1991. And covers the total area of 31 km². It is the smallest wildlife sanctuary in the Arunachal Pradesh, which is important for your prelims. Next is Tale Wildlife Sanctuary. Tale Wildlife Sanctuary is situated in Lower Subansiri district and established in 1995 and covers the total area of 337 km². So Tale Wildlife Sanctuary is also famous for the so many bird species. This wildlife sanctuary is rich with their all kind of avian or bird species. Next is Yordi Rabe Supse Wildlife Sanctuary. इट इज सिचुएटेड इन वेस्ट सियांग डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन 1996 एंड कवर्स द टोटल एरिया ऑफ 397 किलोमीटर ऑफ स्क्वायर. दिस वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी इज ऑल्सो फेमस फॉर मैनी रेयर मैमल स्पीसीज लाइक मस्क डियर, दिस बार्किंग डियर, एलिफेंट, लेपर्ड एंड सो ऑन. लाइकवाइज थ्री टाइगर रिजर्व्स आर ऑल्सो सिचुएटेड इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश. सो हियर यू कैन सी नामदफा टाइगर रिजर्व, कामलांग टाइगर रिजर्व एंड पाके टाइगर रिजर्व. सो नामदफा टाइगर रिजर्व इज ऑल्सो अ नेशनल टाइगर रिजर्व ऑल्सो अ नेशनल पार्क. सो नामदफा नेशनल पार्क इज हैविंग 1800 अराउंड स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ एरिया, बट दिस टाइगर रिजर्व इज हैविंग 2051 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ एरिया. सेकेंड वन इज कामलांग टाइगर रिजर्व. सो कामलांग टाइगर रिजर्व इज ऑल्सो अ वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. सो वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी एंड टाइगर रिजर्व हियर इन कामलांग वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी, बोथ आर टाइगर रिजर्व एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी आर हैविंग सेम एरिया 783 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. एंड थर्ड वन इज पाके टाइगर रिजर्व. सो पाके टाइगर रिजर्व इज ऑल्सो अ पाके वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. सो पाके वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी इज हैविंग लेस एरिया, वेर एज पाके टाइगर रिजर्व इज हैविंग 1191.45 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ एरिया. सो वॉट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर प्रिलिम्स, बिकॉज लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन दिस लेक्चर ऑन दिस और इन दिस प्रोटेक्टेड अबाउट दिस प्रोटेक्टेड एरिया. सो देर आर सो मैनी थिंग्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो हियर यू कैन सी सम ऑफ द प्रीवियस ईयर्स यूपीएससी क्वेश्चंस. सो दीज क्वेश्चन आर ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड दे आर फ्रिक्वेंटली कमिंग इन अल्टरनेट और इन अल्टरनेट ईयर्स. सो इन 2011, 2012, 2013 और दीज क्वेश्चन आर रिपीटिंग सो मैनी टाइम्स इन डिफरेंट वेज. सो हियर ऑल्सो इफ यू कैन सी दीज क्वेश्चंस. So likewise, here we are discussing about some of the previous years APSC questions. So there are so many questions here which have been asked in your previous year questions. So we are giving the questions. If you are going to answer these questions on our YouTube channel, so that may help you and help us as well. Okay, so we are also conducting online classes and we are getting a good positive response of online classes and another physical classes, but in this pandemic season we are only conducting the online classes, and where we are getting very positive responses. And if you are interested, you can register yourself as early as you can. We are also providing complete study material, and we are conducting the test series every weekend, and we are also regular interacting with you with our toppers as well. So now admission is open and enroll yourself as